This week we are pleased to be doing Psalm 141, a Psalm of David. Give ear to my voice. O Lord, I call upon you, hasten to me. Give ear to my voice when I call to you. Let my prayer be counted as incense before you, and the lifting up of my hands as the evening sacrifice. Set a guard, O Lord, over my mouth. Keep watch over the door of my lips. Do not let my heart incline to an evil, to busy myself with wicked deeds. In company with men who work iniquity, and let me not eat of their delicacies. Let a righteous man strike me. It is a kindness. Let him rebuke me. It is oil for my head. Let my head not refuse it. Yet my prayer is continually against their evil deeds. When their judges are thrown over the cliff, then they shall hear my words, for they are pleasant. As when one plows and breaks up the earth, so shall our bones be scattered at the mouth of Sheol. But my eyes are toward you, O God, my Lord. In you I seek refuge. Leave me not defenseless. Keep me from the trap that they've laid for me, and from the snares of evildoers. Let the wicked fall into their own nets, while I pass by safely. This is an individual lament. It is a prayer that God will protect the faithful person against all insincerity and compromise. And so in verses 1 and 2, we've seen the singer asking God to give ear to his voice when he called to him. Say, give ear to my voice when I call to you. His prayer is compared to increase and the evening sacrifice, acts performed in worship. In verses 3 to 5, the singer may be tempted. And so, in verses 3 to 5, the singer may be tempted to avoid danger by joining the men who work iniquity. He asks God to help him avoid all such temptation. This prayer reveals great insight into how a person in such circumstances would actually feel. Verses 6 to 7, as the we've seen, the Hebrew here is difficult. The main point is that eventually God will bring his judgment upon the judges. Then the faithful person will be vindicated, and the unfaithful might even lean or learn wisdom. And lastly, verses 8 to 10, the prayer that God would keep me from falling prey to their schemes becomes a prayer that the wicked would fall into their own nets. Take a minute to say a word to God.
thank you, Lord, because of your love and your glory.
Zambia, kurudi kwa Bwana, mara. Thank you. Oh. good desire.